Hello everyone, welcome back to our YouTube channel Let's Grow. I hope you are very well and doing great in your life. So today's topic of discussion is types of flows in a pipe. So in this video we will see the number of flows, that how many type of flow can take place in a pipe. So in this video we will discuss about the uniform flow, non-uniform flow, streamline flow, turbulent flow, steady flow, unsteady flow, compressible flow, incompressible flow, rotational flow, irrotational flow, one dimensional, two dimensional and three dimensional flow. So we will discuss these types of flows one by one. So initially we will start with the uniform flow, correct? So a flow in which the liquid particles at all sections of a pipe or channel have the same velocities is called a uniform flow, correct? So here you can see a piece of pipe. So on this piece of pipe I take two sections. This is section 1 and this is the another section 2. So if the velocities or hydraulic parameter like the velocity, depth of flow, if these parameters remain same over the space means at different sections, then the flow is called as the uniform flow, correct? So this is our cross section number 1 and this is our cross section number 2. So if for a given time, correct, here we are only see the spatial variation, correct, how the hydraulic parameters are varying with respect to space while the time is remain constant, correct? So this is a time t. So at a given time t, if you measure the velocity or depth at two different sections, section 1 and section 2, and if you find that the velocity and depth of flow or other hydraulic parameters are same, then the flow is called as the uniform flow, correct? So time can be anything. Suppose time is 12:30 a.m. correct? So if you measure the velocity at the same time 12:30 a.m. at both the locations, and if you find the velocity, depth and other hydraulic parameters, and if all these parameters remain same, then it is called as a uniform flow. The second one is the non-uniform flow, correct? A flow in which the liquid particles at different sections of a pipe or a channel have different velocities is called a non-uniform flow, correct? Now the same thing, if we have the two cross section, this is section 1 and this is section 2, correct? And if we measure the velocity or depth of flow at the same time, correct, at the same time at both cross sections, section 1 and section 2, and if the velocities or depth of flows are different at both of the sections, then the flow is called as non-uniform flow, correct? Non-uniform flow means that the velocity or depth of flow are varying at different cross section for a given time, correct? Here time is constant. We are measuring these parameters for a given time t, correct? The another one is the streamline flow, correct? A flow in which each liquid particle has a definite path and the paths of individual particles do not cross each other is called a streamline flow, correct? So what is the meaning of streamline flow? Suppose this is a water molecule or water particle, it is flowing something like this, correct? So it has a definite path, correct? It is flowing a definite path. And the another thing is that it is not coinciding with the another flow path of the other particles, correct? So here I have drawn the flow path of three water molecule, correct? So these are having the definite path, and the path of these three water molecule do not cross each other. So this type of flow is called as the streamline flow. Streamline flow means the flow path is definite and these flow path do not coincide with the other molecule flow path. another is the turbulent flow, correct? A flow in which each liquid particle does not have a definite path and the paths of individual particle also crosses each other is called a turbulent flow. Turbulent means the random. Suppose this is a water molecule or water particle. It is moving randomly, correct? It does not have a definite path and it is moving randomly. So this type of flow is called as the turbulent flow. And another thing is that the flow path of the particles are coinciding, correct? So here we can see that the flow path of other water particles are coinciding. So in turbulent flow, the liquid particle does not have a definite path and it coincides with the another water particle paths, as we have seen in this figure, correct? The next is the steady flow, correct? A flow in which the quantity of liquid flowing per second is constant is called a steady flow, correct? Steady flow means that the liquid flowing per second, that is known as the discharge. If discharge is constant with respect to time, correct? What does it mean? Suppose in this pipe, the Q discharge is passing, Q meter cube per second magnitude of discharge is passing. And this discharge is passing at 3 o'clock. And again, we measure the discharge at 4 o'clock. And again, we measure the discharge at 5 o'clock. And once again, we measure the discharge at 6 o'clock. So what we are doing, we are measuring the discharge at different time period, at an interval of 1 hour. We measure at 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock and 6 o'clock. And if we find that the discharge is constant at all the time, suppose 100 meter cube per second of discharge is passing, and with all these times the discharge remains same. At 3 o'clock, 100 meter cube per second discharge is passing, similarly for 4, 5 and 6. So if the discharge is constant with respect to time, then the flow is called as the steady flow. A steady flow may be uniform or non-uniform, correct? A steady flow may be uniform and non-uniform. How? So suppose the cross-sectional area of this pipe is constant. Here we can see. So if the discharge is constant, the parameters like velocity and the depth of flow will also be constant. So the type of flow will be steady uniform. Uniform steady flow, correct? And if the cross-section of pipe is varying, then the same discharge is passing. That is why flow is steady. But when the cross-section of pipe will change, the velocity and depth of flow will change accordingly. So that flow is known as the steady non-uniform flow, correct? The another one flow is unsteady flow. A flow in which the quantity of liquid flowing per second is not constant is called an unsteady flow, correct? So similarly, the Q discharge is passing in this pipe and we measure the discharge at 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock and 5 o'clock. At 3 o'clock, discharge was 50 meter cube per second. At 4 o'clock, discharge is 100 meter cube per second. And at 5 o'clock, the discharge is 150 meter cube per second. That means our discharge is varying with respect to the time. So if the discharge is varying with respect to time, or the discharge is not constant with time, then the flow take place is called as the unsteady flow, correct? Means the discharge is varying with respect to the time. The other flow is compressible flow. A flow in which the volume of a fluid and its density changes during the flow is called as a compressible flow, correct? Compressible flow means if the fluid density is changing, correct? Like water, for water the density is 100 kg per meter cube, correct? And if this density is varying due to the pressure, then the flow take place is called as the compressible flow, correct? All the gases are considered to have the compressible flow, correct? And we know that water is not a compressible fluid, correct? But all the gases which are present are compressible. So if the fluid is a gas, then the flow will be called as a compressible flow, because gases have a tendency to compress, correct? If you apply some force or pressure, then gas will compress and it will reduce the volume and it will increase the density. So for gases, the flow is compressible. Another flow is incompressible flow, a flow in which the volume of a fluid and its density does not change during the flow is called an incompressible flow, correct? And all the liquids are considered to have incompressible flow. So this is the most important thing, that all the liquids, whether it is water, oil, kerosene, diesel or any other liquids, all these liquids are considered as an incompressible flow, and only gases are considered as compressible flow. Incompressible flow means that your density will not change, correct? Because your your liquid is not compressing. Liquid is not compressing means the volume is not changing. Volume is not changing means it does not affect your density. So density will remain same. Another one flow is rotational flow, correct? A flow in which the fluid particles also rotate. That means they have some angular velocity about their own axis while flowing is called a rotational flow, correct? So to understand this, suppose this is a water molecule, correct? This is a water molecule. This is our water molecule, correct? So if this water molecule have a tendency to rotate, or it has an angular velocity, correct? So if it is rotating like this in clockwise direction, then the flow is called as the rotational flow, correct? This is the same fluid particle and it is rotating like this. It is rotating like this. So it will look like this, correct? It will look something like this. So if the water molecule are rotating about their own axis and possess the angular velocity, then the flow is known as the rotational flow. The next flow is irrotational flow. In flow in which the fluid particles do not rotate about their own axis and retain their original orientation is called as irrotational flow. If the fluid particles do not possess the angular velocity, then they will not rotate about their own axis and they will retain their original orientation. So this type of flow is called as the irrotational flow. Suppose this one particle is here. So this is the orientation of this water molecule, and when it moves and it comes here, it will have the same orientation, correct? This is the same orientation. So this type of flow is called as irrotational flow. Now the another flow is one dimensional flow, a flow in which the streamlines means path of the water molecule or water particle of its moving particle are represented by the straight line is called an one dimensional flow. One dimensional flow means if the streamlines are represented by a straight line, that is known as the one dimensional flow. So if it is a straight line, it is representing a streamline which is the locus of your water molecule, that how a water molecule will move along this path, correct? So if the streamline is straight, then the flow is known as the one dimensional flow, correct? Now two dimensional flow, a flow whose streamline of its moving particles are represented by a curve is called a two dimensional flow, correct? So if there is a curve means if there is a bend or there is a component of velocity in the other dimension, in the two dimension, then the flow is known as the two dimensional flow. So if the streamline is not straight, it has some component in x and y direction, component of velocity, then the flow is known as the two-dimensional flow. Another one is three-dimensional flow, a flow whose streamliner are represented in space. Space means we need three direction, x, y and z, to represent the streamline. That means along the three mutually perpendicular direction, x, y, z, is called a three-dimensional flow, correct? So if we need three dimension x, y and z in space to draw the streamlines, or we need three velocities to represent the flow, then the flow is known as three dimensional, streamlines are straight and one velocity component is required. In two dimensions, the streamlines are represented by a curve and two velocity components are required to represent the flow. In three dimensionals, a space means three mutually perpendicular directions are required and three separate velocity component, vx, vy and vz, are required to represent the flow. So this is all about the types of flow in pipe. If you really like this video, make sure you hit that like button. You can also subscribe our channel Let's Grow for more informative videos. Thank you so much to watch this lesson till the end. Happy learnings with Let's Grow. Okay, take care. Bye-bye.